About preparing for a preseason game is about what you want to do as opposed to scouting what the other team does?
Well, most of it in exhibition games especially is all about us and how we're improving and what we need to do with personnel and those things. But you get to this time, you know, where you actually got a game on Saturday, the process of preparation, I think, with this exhibition game here on Wednesday has been a lot more about what they do and how they do it and how we can respond to it and guard it. And then, you know, it's going to be, I would say that the first couple have been a lot more about us, but I think that the process of this, we've spent a lot of time on them and what we think they're going to do when they come in here. They played one exhibition game, and so we do have a film and can see that, and we've got some film from last year. And they're similar to Westminster, where they have a lot of returning players, a lot of seniors, and it's a good team. They run good stuff, and I'm excited to see how our guys actually respond to this type of game.
Do you like having an exhibition game this close to the start of the season?
Well, you know, we've done this quite a different ways, and with our game on Saturday, it's a really long week, and so I think we broke it up this way. And what we're trying to do every day is get better, but we're trying to keep it fresh with our guys. And I thought that if we played the exhibition game in the middle of the week, that we would kind of get started on the way it's going to work the next couple of weeks. We got a midweek game next week, come home, play a Saturday game, and then got a midweek game, and then we go, I think it's a Monday or Tuesday game, and then we go back to New York again. So kind of get us started on what the procedure will be here in the next couple of weeks.
Do you feel like you have a good feel for the identity of this team? Is it still a work in progress?
I think it's still working, you know, it's still working its way through. I mean, the fact that, you know, we've been so healthy going through this, and we've talked about it, and then, you know, Braden sprained his ankle on Saturday, and so he won't, you know, be available for probably this week, at least for sure. This is important. It's an important game. It's an important game for a lot of the guys that have played some minutes and really not played as well as they need and want to or are capable of, to get comfortable doing that. And then it's important for the guys that maybe haven't played a lot of minutes to get some minutes and then be able to respond to it. So hopefully that'll happen. We'll see.
Is Nick helping now?
Nick's feeling better, yeah, but Nick won't play this weekend. I mean, this week for sure. It's kind of part of the plan, we're still trying to figure out information from the NCAA, so he won't be available.
Won't be available tomorrow night or Saturday?
Or Saturday night. Well, he won't play this week.
In what ways do you feel like this team has gotten better since you've got them all together for the official practices?
Well, I think that it's a team that has really grasped our defensive concepts. You know, it's a real small sampling, and but the two nights of the you know, the team shooting threes against us have been, you know, in New Mexico they shot way too many, but they only shot 17%, and then we guarded Westminster pretty good from the perimeter, at least in the first half. That's a big improvement, I think, for our team. We'll see. We'll see as we continue to move on. But that's by design, and I think our guys are adjusting to that pretty well. Offensively, I think that our ability to be efficient, especially on the second and third side of the floor, is way better. You look at our first side attempts, and we're shooting in the low 30s. You look at our second and third side attempts, and we're shooting in 60% range. And that's something that is important to us as the season moves along, for us to get better in a half-court offense.
What do you mean second and third side?
When you bring it up and the ball hits one side, it gets reversed to the second side, okay. And then it gets reversed to the third side. We've always been a really good first side team, but as the possession gets a bit longer, we're not nearly as efficient, and I think this team can be a lot more efficient as we continue to play side to side to side later in the shot clock.
One of the things you were emphasizing, you said last month, was to stop the other team's three-point shooting attempts. How do you think through two exhibition games you kind of?
Well, you know, the first exhibition game, we were pretty you know, I mean, we're just surprised that, you know, New Mexico got that many threes off against us, but they just scrimmaged Denver the other day and they made 17 in the game, scored 125 points. So maybe we did a little better job than we thought we'd done, but I think that is an emphasis every day in practice. And, you know, hopefully we can get that number, instead of, you know, where teams are shooting an average of 22, 23 against us, that you know, they're shooting more like 15 or 16. And that's kind of the number that we're looking for.
Dave, you said it after the Westminster game that you put a lot of guys in positions where you just wanted to see where they're at. How do you kind of tighten your rotation now going into this game and then into the season opener and then moving forward?
Well, I think that we've made some adjustments. You know, we've got a couple guys that are still playing perimeter and post positions. You can't put too many guys in those positions because that's a hard transition back and forth. Zach seems to be doing a pretty good job with it. But I think that you know, right now we have Dalt and Luke and Yoli and Peyton in those post positions. Zach can swing down there, but hopefully all four of those guys can play some major minutes here and we can get some production out of them and see how it works. Our perimeter guys, you know, I feel pretty good about it. Those are the guys that, you know, have the most experience and hopefully that you know, they'll be able to carry the load for a while. What I really want to have happen is I want them both to complement each other. I think that sometimes that you have, you know, really talented front courts and back courts, but maybe they don't mesh really well together. And hopefully that this group will really complement each other. And we'll get good defensive possessions and, you know, good physical rebounding out of our post guys. And then, you know, our guards can really guard the perimeter and keep our post guys out of foul trouble. So,
what have you seen Zach's progression from the time he returned from his mission to now and overcoming the shoulder problems and things like that?
Yeah, I think that Zach has been on just a constant upward plane, you know, and he just continues to, he hasn't had a lot of setbacks. He's had a few times in practice where he's twinged it pretty good and it's been sore, but it's recovered pretty quickly, which is good. He really spends a lot of time with it. You know, he and Rob Ramos, a trainer, and Eric Shork, our strength conditioning guy, they do a lot of things to keep it strong. And so, you know, Tyler Haas had that problem a few years ago, and by the end of the season, it just was, he had worked so hard and was so consistent in his rehab that it, you know, his shoulder, you know, the hurt shoulder is probably stronger than the shoulder that wasn't hurt the first of the year. So hopefully that's what happens with Zach.
You've seen so many guys in your career come here to play, go on a mission, come back different, both good and bad. Was there anything that kind of stood out about Zach when he came home of, like, oh, I don't remember that, but, you know, that's nice.
He looks bigger than me. I mean, I think he grew maybe half an inch, but he just looked like, you know, a bigger, more established, ready to, you know, to be a Division I factor. I mean, he was a really good player as a freshman, really shot the ball well, came off the bench, but I think he's got a chance to, you know, to really not only help this team, but just individually have a great Division I college career.
Is it safe to say then that Nick won't play until you hear back from the NCAA?
That's pretty safe to say. Yeah, that's how I understand it.
So when you said this is part of the plan, that was basically...
Well, with the exhibition games, we knew that he could play in, and then this week I didn't want to. I wanted to get ready for our Saturday game, and there's no reason to, you know, play a guy that's not going to play, in my opinion. So that's where we are.
Is there any timetable that the NCAA has given you? Do you have any clue when they'll let you know?
That they haven't told me, but they're not communicating with me. So I'm just waiting to hear from our compliance people and administration.
Anything else?